Welcome to ICS, or the International Church of Shanghai. I'm so glad you can be with us today. In just a moment, we have a time to enter into a time of praise and worship with our worship team, and right after that, the preaching of the Word. But first, here are some announcements in the life of our church.
We continue to worship online as we await the restart of our church. As soon as we hear any further news, we will let you know. We thank you for your ongoing patience and prayers. Please note that ICS is a multi-denominational Christian church. In compliance with local government regulations, ICS online services and events are open to foreign passport holders only.
Cell groups. One thing we truly value at ICS is community. Whether you're joining us for the first time or you have been joining ICS for quite some time already, cell groups are where you can develop real and lasting friendships to support one another that go beyond greetings or quick chat at church on Sunday morning. Are you interested to do Bible study? At ICS, we offer a discipleship program by partnering with CBSI for their Bible study lessons and materials. Some of the cell groups have started the study already. So come on! Join our cell groups. To find a cell group that's perfect for you, please scan the QR code or send us an email to view any of your requests. We'll reach out to get you connected right away.
With the new ICS phone app, you can access online services, sermons, daily devotionals, and everything on the ICS website with ease in one place. Download yours now. Available on the Apple Store and Google Play Store. And for more details, please scan the QR code. Have you had your daily bread today? Our body needs food every day, and so does our spirit. ICS devotionals can help you start off your day with a short message, along with some scriptures to meditate upon. ICS Kids Church now also has daily devotionals for your kids. And ICS Trailblazers also provides devotionals for the youth. All these three devotionals can be accessed on our ICS website or on our ICS app, or just simply scan the QR code. So check out our very own ICS devotionals if you haven't already. Start reading and sharing our daily devotionals to those who may be missing out.
It has been a difficult 3 years for COVID policy. I believe that those who suffer the most are the ones at the lower strata of society. It is for this reason that we have come together to play golf and also to do a good cause at the same time. I'd like to express my gratitude to all the sponsors. And those of you who have come out to play. But let's remind ourselves the very reason that we are doing this is to make sure that we will be a blessing to those who are in need. Thank you very much.
Hello there. TEC prepares many exciting events all year round to keep the community connected. Here are just a few. Find out more by scanning the respective event's QR code. Do continue to follow TEC through our official WeChat account or TEC mini program to get involved. Stay connected, be a blessing.
We want to thank all our members for your tithes and offerings. It makes a real difference, not only to the operations of our church, but allowing us to be blessed to bless the community around us. If you're new with us, don't feel any obligations whatsoever. We're just so glad you can be with us here today. If you have come prepared to give, please note ICS as a new bank tithes and offerings QR code using Alipay or WeChat Pay. Please leave the payment remarks in the remittance blank or without inputting anything. If you prefer to give via local bank transfer, please scan the QR code for the bank account information. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us. Thank you so much for your support to ICS.
Okay, let us come together for a time of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father God, Lord, we pray and we thank you, Lord God, that you're bringing us together, Father God, to praise and worship you and to hear your word today. We pray and thank you, Lord God, for our praise and worship team and the unique gifts and talents that you have blessed them to be able to unify us as one body and one voice to praise and worship you. And Lord, we also want to uplift Pastor Daniel and Pastor Kelly into your arms right now and ask, Lord God, that you bless them with wisdom, clarity and conviction as they preach your word, Father God. Let it go forth and not return void. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Be quiet. I'm gonna shout out your praise. There's joy in the house. totally leaving, dancing in silent skies, brilliance of morning, breaking day. Oh, let them praise Him, praise His name.
Praise His name. Oh, praise His name.
deserve all the glory, all the power, all the honor. We lift you up, we lift you up.
To give you an update in regards to our church reopening, and we have contacted the District Religious Affairs Bureau last week. They have informed us that the Fang Kong department has given them some in principle approval, and they will be calling for a meeting this coming week with the Jie Tao and also the Tong Zhan Bu department in regards to our church reopening. So do continue to pray. I know it has been a very difficult 33 months for all of us. But at the same time, there are also outbreaks in different districts in Shanghai. Let's pray that Changning will not have any outbreak these couple of weeks so that we will be able to reopen smoothly. Okay? Praise God. So I'd like to address a very important topic that's been weighing in my heart for some time.
我想谈谈一个长期萦绕在我心头的话题。
It is a topic on gender confusion and homosexuality.
这是一个关于性别困惑和同性恋的话题。
It will be a two-part sermon series.
这是一个两部分组成的讲道系列。
I know that it is a very sensitive topic.
我知道这是一个非常敏感的话题。
But it will be good for us to address it from a biblical perspective.
但是最好是从圣经的角度来讨论它。
I would like to give the church standpoint so that we are clear in handling the issue, regardless of whether we are facing it at home or not.
我想表达教会的立场，这样我们可以清楚地处理这个问题，不管我们是否需要在家里面对它。
I'm convinced that every parent should be wise in educating our children in regards to what the Bible teaches as compared to what is being advocated in the world.
我相信每一位家长都应该明确的、明智的教育他们的孩子，让他们了解圣经所教导的，而不是世上所倡导的。
We must not wait until something happened to their emotions or thinking to address it.
我们不能等到他们的情绪或者想法发生了变化以后才去解决它。
There are so many voices that's clamoring for their attention as they struggle through different issues in their lives.
当他们在努力解决生活中的各种问题的时候，有太多的声音想要争取他们的注意力。
If we do not educate them with the Bible, what the Bible teaches, then the world will educate them differently.
如果我们不按圣经的教导去教导他们的话，他们世界就会去教导他。
Honestly, it's already a challenge if your children are advocating that everyone should have the right to choose their choice of lifestyle.
老实说，如果你的孩子主张每个人都有权选择自己的生活方式的话，这已经是一个大的挑战。
This is one of the important topics to teach or discuss earlier with them to bring up our children in the ways of the Lord as we have taught.Been taught in the Bible.
这是我们需要早点教他们或者跟他们讨论的重要话题之一，使我们能够像圣经中教导的那样，按照主的方式抚养我们的孩子。
The Bible is the infallible word of God.
圣经是神绝对正确的话。
As Christians, we should never use what's happening in the world to determine whether the Bible is relevant to us now.
作为基督徒，我们永远不应该用世上发生的事情来决定圣经现在是否与我们有关。
His word is the yardstick or the plumb line for us to measure what is right and wrong in society.
他的话就是我们衡量社会上的对与错的标尺和准线。
This should be the way, regardless of whether we are living in a predominantly Christian or atheist country.
不论我们生活在是以基督教为主的国家，还是无神论为主的国家。
In Lisa, His word is truly a lamp to our feet and a light unto our path.
他的话是我们脚前的灯和路上的光。
It leads us in the right and correct path in life.
他引导我们走上正确的人生道路。
Once we choose to ignore the word, then we will stray away from the path of righteousness and compromise with the world.
一旦我们选择忽视神的话语，我们就会偏离公义的道路，而与世界妥协。
The Bible is the authority in the lives of every believer of Jesus Christ.
圣经是每个耶稣基督信徒生命中的权威。
In fact, it is the handbook for all humanity because He's the God of all creation.
事实上，它是全人类的生命手册，因为它是。创造所有造物的神。
Therefore, the Bible has the authority to speak into the current confusion and deliver people out of deception of the devil that aims to destroy the next generation.
因此，圣经有权柄直面当前的混乱，将人们从旨在毁灭下一代的魔鬼的欺骗中解救出来。
Turn with me to the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, verse 7, verse 27 to 29.
我们一起看创世纪一章二十七到二十八节。
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Then God blessed them, and God said to them, Be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth.
神就照着自己的形象造人，乃是照着他的形象造男造女。神就赐福给他们，又对他们说，要生养众多，遍满地面，治理这地，也要管理海里的鱼，空中的鸟，和地上各样行动的活物。
If we are to return to Genesis, it is very clear that God made Adam and Eve to be partners for life.
如果我们回到创世纪的话，很明显，神让亚当和夏娃成为生命的伴侣。
The Bible started with a marriage between a man and a woman, and ends with the church being the bride of Christ in the book of Revelation.
圣经从一男一女的婚姻开始，到启示录中教会成为基督的新娘为止。
It is always about a man and a woman.
它总是关于一个男人和一个女人。
The sexuality is very clear.
性别是非常明确的。
There is absolute gender clarity in God's creation.
在神的创造中有绝对清晰的性别。
There was never a time when a man chooses to become a woman or a woman to be a man.
从来没有男人选择成为女人或者女人选择成为男人的时候。
God did not create transgender.
神并没有创造变性人。
We live in a broken and fallen world.
我们是生活在一个堕落和破碎的世界里。
However, I would like to say that there's hope because of the work of redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ.
但是我想指出的是，我们有希望，因为耶稣基督在十字架上的救赎工作。
Now, let me lay the foundation.
让我为大家奠定一个基础。
There is gender confusion.
我们有性别的困惑。
Some people think that, you know, they are born a boy, but maybe they are a girl.
有的人认为他可能生下来是男孩，可能他们应该是个女孩。
Yeah, there's gender fluidity.
有性别的这个流动性。
Which they say, you know, I can choose at different stages of my life whether I want to be a man or be a woman, regardless of the binary that I've been born into.
就不管我出生是什么性别，在我生命的不同阶段，我可以选择成为一个男人或成为一个女人。
So I would like to let you know that regardless of the school that your children come from, they will be influenced by this thinking.
我想告诉大家，不管你们的孩子是在什么学校上学，他们都会受到这样的影响。
You will be able to watch it on YouTube on the different social media platform.
你可以在 YouTube 或者不同的社交媒体上看到这些。
And you will hear about it in the corporate world.
你在公司里可能也会听到这些。
Right? If you're a human resource person, you got to talk about being inclusive.
如果你在人力资源部工作的话，你们可能会一直倡导说要包。接纳所有人。
So as Christian parents and as Christian, how are we able to navigate through all this confusion?
所以作为基督徒和基督徒的父母来说，我们怎么才能够面对这些困惑呢？
Does the church have an answer for this?
我们教会有没有一个答案呢？
I can tell you there is.
我想告诉大家有的。
So allow me to lay this foundation of the new creation reality so that we will know how we can live differently from the world.
所以请允许我为新造之人的这个事实奠定基础，让我们知道我们可以用不同于世界的方式来生活。
Basically, new creation realities is referring to the born-again experience, having God's nature in our spirit man, possesses the fruit of the Holy Spirit and empowered by the Holy Spirit.
根本上来说，新造之人是指重生的经历，在我们的灵人中有神的本性，拥有圣灵的果实，并由圣灵赋予力量。
It is an abundant and victorious life.
这是丰盛而得胜的生活。
Now, let me leave my script for a while. Yeah. Now, many of you have been to different parts of the world.
你们很多人都去过世界不同的地方。
Maybe some of you will be posted to another country for your work in due time.
你们可能因为工作被派遣到别的国家。
And you will hear of all this confusion.
你会听到各种各样的困惑。
You will be visiting churches who believes in being okay to have this gender fluidity.
你去的教会有可能是认为性取向的这个流动性是可以被接受的。
There are churches who believe that homosexuality is okay.
有的教会认为同性恋也是 okay 的。
Let me tell you from the Bible, it is not okay.
我想告诉大家的是，圣经上说这并不对。
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, so how are we supposed to live our life differently? Can our life be different in the midst of all this confusion?
所以在这一切的困惑中，我们是否能够与世界不同的来生活？
Because let me tell you, one day if you have children growing up in your family,
当某一天你家的孩子长大成人的时候，
No, if yeah, and your children will ask you this question one day.
你的孩子有可能会问你这个问题。
How are you going to answer them?
你那个时候会怎么回答他呢？
As adult, you must be equipped to answer them correctly.
作为一位成年人，你应该要有能力能够回答他，正确的回答他。
Let me be very frank.
让我非常坦白的对大家说。
As a parent,
作为父母
，bringing up our children in the ways of the Lord does not equate to bringing them to church only.
按主的方式抚养我们的孩子，并不等同于只是把他们带到教会来。
It is important to bring your children to church.
把他们带到教会来当然很重要。
But the more important part is for you to journey with them daily.
但更重要的是每天与他们同行。
As they ask you questions about what they are hearing from the world, you must be able to tell them from the biblical perspective regarding how they should live their life.
当他们从世上听到各种世上不同的声音的时候，你应该要能按照圣经的方式告诉他们我们应该怎么生活。
That's what it means to bring your children up in the ways of the Lord.
这才是按主抚养教养我们孩子的方式。
It is done daily.
这是每天的工作。
In your daily conversation with them.
当你每天跟他们对话的时候。
Because you must be that positive voice of influence.
你必须要是他们生命中非常积极的那个正向的力量。
Okay, and you tell them how can we live differently.
你可以告诉他们我们怎么才能跟世界不同的生活。
So I'm going to tell you how can we be different.
我想要告诉大家我们怎么才能做到。
We have the promises.
我们有神的应许。
We have the hope.
我们有希望。
We have the ability to live a life that is very different from the world.
我们有能力按照与世界不同的方式来生活。
Second Peter chapter 1 verse 2 to 4.
我们来看一下彼得后书二章彼得后书一章二到四节。
Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord, as his divine power has given us all things that pertains to life and godliness.Through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through this you may be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that's in the world through lust.
愿恩惠平安，因你们认识神和我们主耶稣，多多的加给你们。神的神能已将一切关乎生命和近前的事情赐给我们，皆因我们认识那用自己荣耀和美德招我们的主，因此他已将又宝贵又极大的应许赐给我们，叫我们既脱离世上从情欲来的败坏，就得与神的性情有份。
Now, if we have the knowledge of the truth regarding the redemption realities, then the truth will set us free.
如果我们知道关于救赎的真理，那么真理将使我们自由。
Of course, we will constantly enforce the victory of Jesus and push back the forces of darkness during our time on earth.
当然，当我们还在世上的日子，我们将不断地实现耶稣的得胜来抵制黑暗国度的势力。
The key to overcoming the passionate and illicit sexual desire, regardless of whether it's natural or unnatural, is found in these few verses.
克服自然或者非自然的激情和不正当的情欲的关键就在于这几节经文。
It says God's divine power, which refers to the same power of the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, resides in us.
神的神能指的是那具有将耶稣从死里复活的同样力量的圣灵住在我们里面。
We need to have this knowledge of the truth.
我们需要了解这个真理。
There are many promises in the scripture that assure us that we can overcome temptation and walk in godliness.
圣经中有许多应许向我们保证我们可以克服诱惑尽前行事。
This is true because we have the nature of God in our heart.
这是真的，因为我们心中有神的性情。
We do live in a fallen and broken world.
我们的确是生活在一个堕落破碎的世界里。
We will not be perfect until the new heaven and earth appears.
直到新天新地出现才会变为完美。
Sin is lawlessness, self-centeredness, and living apart from God.
罪是毫无律法，以自我为中心远离神的生活。
Now let me give youWhat it says here in the scripture says that the divine nature of God has helped us to escape the corruption in the world through lust.
神的神性帮助我们能够抵制各种情欲。
Right? So what is lust?
什么是情欲？
Lust can be natural lust.
它可能是自然的。
A man lusting after a woman.
男人喜爱女人。
Right? A man lusting after a woman in the office.
他可能被办公室里的一个女性同事所吸引。
That is lust.
那个是情欲的诱惑。
A man lusting after a man is also lust.
而一个男人喜欢男人也是情欲的一种。
This is what the Bible says, the corruption that's in the world.
这是圣经所说的世上的败坏。
Corruption that's in the world through lust.
它是通过情欲而产生的败坏。
So the Bible is telling us that there is these promises in the Bible.
所以圣经告诉我们，圣经里有应许。
That help you to escape the corruption in the world through lust.
能够帮助你摆脱这些属世的情欲的败坏。
Is that what the Bible says?
这是圣经所说的。
So what I'm trying to say is, even if someone has been practicing homosexuality or being confused in their gender, there's hope that they are able to take hold of the promises of God to overcome the corruption that is in the world.True lust.
所以即使一个人是被有性别的困惑或者是同性恋，但是通过神的应许，他是能够摆脱这些情欲的败坏的。
Amen.
Amen.
Because the nature of God lives in us.
因为我们心中有神的神性。
Right? Regardless whether it is natural or unnatural, we will be able to overcome that.
不管是自然还是非自然的，我们都能够克服它。
Why do I say that?
为什么我要这么说？
Because before you were saved.
因为你被得救之前，
you were a slave to sin.
你是罪的奴仆。
For example,
比如说，
before you were saved.
你被得救之前，
since you are a slave to sin.
你是罪的奴仆。
And you are dictated by your feelings.
你被你的情感所控制。
You are dictated by the lust of the flesh.
你被你肉体的情欲所控制。
People will fall into fornication and adultery.
有的人可能会去有的人可能会去做偷情或者私情的事情。
Right. So before someone was saved.
所以当得救之前。
The person might have gender fluidity.
这个人可能有性取向的流动性。
But.After they are saved,
但是他们得救之后，
they break free from the bondage of sin.
他们就从罪的束缚中被解救出来。
They are born again.
他们也是重生的人。
They have the new creation.
他们是新造的人。
They are able to walk in the newness of life.
他们可以走在新的生命里面。
These are the promises.
这是神的应许。
That help us to escape the corruption that is the world through lust.
帮助我们逃脱从情欲而来的败坏。
So what I'm trying to tell you is there's hope.
所以我想告诉大家的是有希望。
We need to be wise in regards to how we journey with our children.
我们要明智地跟我们的孩子同行。
This is the very reason why ICS invests in having 6 kids church staff and kids church and youth workers in our church.
这也是为什么 ICS 安排了六位少年和青少年事工的同工，在跟孩子们一起同行。
It is not their responsibility to bring your children up in the ways of the Lord, although they will partner you in bringing up your children in the ways of the Lord.
虽然这不是他们的职责，按主的方式来抚养孩子，但是他们会跟父母们一起，一起结伴来抚养孩子。
We are partners in ministry.
我们是在事工里的合作伙伴。
In bringing up our children in the ways of the Lord.
按主的方式来抚养我们的孩子。
Amen.
Amen.
Now, why do we call our youth ministry the trailblazer?
为什么我们叫我们的青少年事工是开拓者呢？
It's so that they will be different from the world.
是因为这样他们可以与世界不同。
Now, let me give you an example.
让我给大家个例子。
When they go to school,
当他们去学校的时候，
some schools will say that, you know, we accept agender children.
有的学校说我们接受无性别的孩子。
And that means...One day they might feel that they are a boy. One day they might feel that they are a girl.
这意味着有一天他认为自己是女孩，有一天又认为他可能是个男孩。
They can go to whichever toilet that they choose, depending on what they feel that day.
他们可以按当天他的感觉来决定去哪一个洗手间。
Some of them, when they wake up one day, and feel that you know today I'm a girl, so I dress as a girl to go to school.
有的孩子早上醒来觉得今天自己是女孩，所以就穿上女孩的衣服去学校。
Some people say it's okay to have love for the same sex.
那有的人还会说，对同性的爱是可以的。
They're bombarded by all these things.
他们被所有这些信息轰炸。
And because of peer pressure, they might succumb to it.
而因为同才的这个压力，他们就被迫接受它。
What is a trailblazer?
那么开拓者又是什么
？A trailblazer is someone who say no.
开拓者会说不
I don't subscribe to all this.
我并不接受这一切。
The Bible tells me that God created male and female.
圣经告诉我们，神创造了男人和女人。
I'm born a boy.
我生下来就是个男孩。
I will grow up as a man.
我会长大成为一个男人。
I will marry a woman.
我会和一个女人结婚。
I don't care what y'all believe.
我不关心你们相信的是什么。
This is what I believe.
这是我所相信的。
This is what the Bible teaches me.
这也是圣经教导我的。
This is what my parents teaches me.
这也是我的父母教导我的。
I choose to be different.
我选择跟世界不同。
In the midst of confusion.
在所有这些困惑中间。
This is a trailblazer.
这就是开拓者。
It takes someone to stand up for their belief.
他站出来，持守自己的信心。
We want to raise up a generation like this.
我们想要养大的是这样的一代人。
And we need you to partner with us.
而我们需要父母们跟我们一起合作。
And I want to speak to the parents today.
我想跟所有的父母说
话。The work of this ministry does not belong to the church workers.
这个工作并不只是属于我们教会的事工。
The church worker is to partner you.
教会的同工是跟你合作。
Bringing up the children in the ways of the Lord is a daily affair.
把孩子按主的方式来抚养是我们每天的工作。
How does it happen?
那怎么才能做到呢
？Let's say when you go home one every day.
让我们说你每天回家的时候。
And you have a meal with over the table with your family.
你和你的家人一起坐在桌前吃饭。
Or you probably will be asking how was your day.
你可能会问，你今天过得怎么样啊？
If your children are open and frank with you,
如果你的孩子对你非常的开放，
and you are very close to them,
你跟他们也非常的亲近，
they won't say, okay.
他们不会说、
Many children
没什么。
Today is just okay.
很多孩子今天跟父母就是说，
because、
哎呀，没什么。
They're not interested to tell you.
他们并不感兴趣跟你分享他的生活。
But if you build a good relationship with them,
但是如果你跟他有很好的关系，
and you have been journeying with them,
你每天都跟他同行。
They will tell you that.
他会告诉你父亲
today,
今天我班上有个人说
this boy says that he likes me.
这个男孩说他喜欢我
boy,、right?
你的孩子假设你的孩子是个儿子啊
What would you say?
你会怎么说
Like him back
爱回去不会
The generation of today in this gender confusion
今天在性别困惑的这一代人中
Some of them might grow up in a dysfunctional family.
有的孩子可能是在一个失调的家庭中长大的。
Some of them might grow up in a single parent family.
有的可能是在单亲家庭中长大的。
Some of them might grow up in a gay family.
有的可能是在同性恋的家庭中长大的。
So they're looking for love and acceptance.
他们想要爱和接纳。
They are very insecure.
他们非常没有安全感。
They don't know what is love.
他们不知道什么是爱。
So, you know, even between a boy and a girl, there's this time called infatuation. I mean, if you have been a young person before, you know what infatuation is, right?
So, yeah,
are you here or you're on earth or you're not from this earth? Do you understand what is infatuation?
Yeah.
所以男孩和女孩之间会有吸引力，互相吸引。
对。When you're 15-year-old, you know, as a young boy and you kind of like your...classmate, the girl, the 校花 in your class, right? Or your school, right? That's infatuation.
对，当你是十五岁的男孩的时候，你非常喜欢你们学校的校花，那长得很漂亮的女生，这是男孩女孩之间的吸引。
Never been through this stage before.
难道你们都没有经历过这个阶段吗？
So let's go back to this story.
让我们回到刚才的故事。
So how are you supposed to talk to your son?
所以你怎么对你的儿子说呢？回应呢？
If a boy that approached your son saying that he loves your son and it's that kind of sexual love, you should tell your son that no, this is not natural.
如果有个男孩来接近你的儿子，跟他说他爱你，而且是那种同性之间的爱，你要告诉你的儿子这个是不自然的。
No, we. This is how we should educate our children.
这是我们应该如何教育我们的孩子的方式。
Right, going back to the Bible.
我们回到圣经。
Genesis says.
创世纪说。
God created male and female.
神造男造女。
God created Adam and Eve.
神创造了亚当和夏娃。
Not Adam and Steve.
不是亚当和 Steven.
Right. It's very simple. You have to tell your children. You have to journey with your children.
你必须要告诉自己的孩子，也跟他们同行。
Now, we will be very carnal and live like the people of the world if we are dictated by the soul, mind, and carnal desires.
如果我们被魂心思意念啊，肉体欲望啊，和身体的这些感觉所支配。
Now, let's have the diagram up here, please.
让我们看一下这个图。
Now, it is in Chinese, but basically, the new creation realities tells us that we are born again.
我们新造的事实告诉我们，我们重生了。
We are new creation.
我们是全新的。
We are made in righteousness and holiness.
我们是公义和圣洁的。
We are connected with God.
我们与神连结。
We grow spiritually through the word of God.
我们通过神的话语来成长。
So we are supposed to rule and reign in our spirit man.
我们应该是在灵里面。灵人里面
yeah, but a lot of Christians,
但是很多基督徒
is living in the realm of the soul.
人就住在这个魂的这个领域里面。
The soul is full of I, me, and myself.
这个魂的领域都是我啊，我自己。
We are very self-centered.
我们是非常自我中心的。
And the lust of the flesh comes from the five senses.
而肉体的诱惑是来自于我们的五感。
What we see,
我们看到的。
What are you watching on the internet?
你现在在网上都看的是什么？
Your children right now, you can't even monitor because the phone is connected to the internet. The phone itself is a computer.
现在你都没办法来监控你的孩子，因为他弄手机就可以上网。
What they watch?
他们看的是什么？
What they're hearing?
他们听的是什么？
What they're reading?
他们读的是什么？
Influences their feelings.
这些都影响他们的感觉、感情。
Feelings are not accurate.
感觉是不准确的。
Let me give an example.
让我给一个例子。
Let's say today there's a 13-year-old boy.
假设说今天有个13岁的男孩。
Yep. And he is very neglected in the family.
他在家庭很被忽视。
Maybe he come from a divorce, a single parent family.
他可能是来自离异单亲的家庭。
His father is never around. His father is not with him.
他的父亲从来不在身边。
He's looking for love.
他想要寻求爱。
And all of a sudden,
忽然间
，because he has watched all these video about gender fluidity.
因为他看了很多关于性倾向流动性的这些短视频。
Because he has no foundation.
因为他没有。很好的基础。
If it goes by pure feelings,
如果纯粹是按照他的感觉行事的话
he has feelings for this boy,
他对这个男孩有感情。
He doesn't know whether this feeling is a longing for love from a person.
他不知道这个感情实际上是渴望别人的爱
or sexual love,
还是性方面的爱。
Because nobody is educating him.
因为从来没有人教育过他。
Because the parent has no time for him.
因为父母也没有时间给他。
That's why they become very chaotic.
所以他们就变得非常混乱，他们很困惑。
And the pop idols that they follow.
然后他们追的这些明星
，the influencer on the internet.
而网络上的这些影响
，mold their mind.
塑造了他们的心思意念。
When a pop idol comes out and say, "I'm agender."
当一个明星告诉他们说，我是一个没性无性别人。
And this 12-year-old boy thinks that it's very cool.
这个十二岁的男孩可能说：“哎呀，这个好酷啊！”
And when they have such feelings,
当他们有这种感情产生的时候
it affirms what their friends are telling them.
这就更进一步确认了他们的朋友告诉他们的事情。
It affirms what the world is telling them.
确认了世界所告诉他们的事情。
And if they do not have the word of God in their mind,
如果他没有神的话语的话
，if they do not renew their mind with the word of God,
如果神的话语没有更新他们的心思意念的话
，and they do not know how to walk in the spirit,
他们也不知道如何行在灵里的话
，they will continue to walk in the world with their soul.
他们会始终在他这个魂里面运作。
They will be led by their feelings.
他们会被自己的感情所带领。
And they will do silly things.
他们可能会做愚蠢的事情。
So my question to you is.
所以我对大家的问题是。
Are you the positive voice of influence in the life of your children?
你是不是你孩子生命中的正向引导力？
Let me tell you, the internet is a voice.
我们告诉你，网络是一个声音。
Social media is a voice.
社交媒体也是声音。
Pop idol is a voice.
明星又是一个声音。
What the school advocate is a voice.
学校里可能倡导的也是一个声音。
Their peers is a voice.
他的同学们也有声音。
It could be negative voices.
这些都可能是负面的影响。
That advocates gender confusion.
在倡导性别的困惑。
But you must be the godly positive voice in their lives.
但你必须是要属神的、敬虔的、正向的引导力。
The youth working in the church will work together with you.
而我们教会的青少年事工会跟你一起合作。
To reinforce the biblical truth.
来强调我们属圣经的真理。
To give them a direction out of the confusion.
把他们从困惑中领出来，给他们方向。
But you as parents must make time for your children.
但是你作为父母要给你们的孩子留时间。
Now let me go down to the next point.
让我们看接下来的这个点。
I need to lay this foundation of the Christian marriage.
我还要为大家在基督徒的婚姻上面为大家奠定一个基础。
Verse 28 says, and then God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it, have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth."
创世纪一章二十八节，神就赐福给他们，又对他们说：“要生养众多，遍满地面，治理这地，也要管理海里的鱼、空中的鸟和地上各样行动的活物。”
The married couple are to give each other companionship.
婚姻中夫妇要彼此陪伴。
Now, this is a God-ordained natural family unit where the husband and wife should consummate their marriage and bear children.
这是一个神指定的自然的家庭单位，丈夫和妻子应该在这里完成他们的婚姻，并生育孩子。
There must be a male and a female to consummate the marriage and to give birth to babies to fill the earth.
必须有一男一女来完成婚姻，生下孩子们，充满各地。
They are to play the role of husband and wife, father and mother on the earth.
他们在世上扮演丈夫和妻子、父亲和母亲的角色。
This is the kind of family nuclear that God intended.
这是神所希望的家庭核心。
The man is to leave his parents and cleave to his wife, and they become one flesh.
男人要离开他的父母，忠于他的妻子，他们将成为一体。
They are to establish the marriage covenant as a couple.
他们将以夫妻的身份订立婚姻的盟约。
It is a marriage where the man is to love his wife and himself.
在婚姻中，男人要爱他的妻子和自己。
The family unit is the most basic nuclear in society.
家庭单位是社会基本的核心单位。
It must be protected at all costs.
我们必须不惜一切代价来保护它。
If it's broken, changed, or given an alternative, then the entire society will be in trouble.
如果它被打破、改变或被替代，那么整个社会都会陷入困境。
It will be a very dysfunctional unit.
这会是一个非常功能异常的单位。
The children will be confused, and the ripple effect in society will be great.
孩子们会感到困惑，社会的连锁反应也会很大。
This is one of the reasons for all the gender confusion and the problem of LGBTQ of today.
这是所有性别困惑的原因之一，也是当今 LGBT， 也就是同性、双性恋、变性造成的问题。
The family unit has disintegrated.
家庭单位已经被瓦解了。
Now let me give an example.
让我给大家一个例子。
If a gay couple was to adopt a child and it happened to be a girl, then the girl will not be able to turn to the mother.Who is supposed to be the same gender as her to confide in her?
如果一对同性恋夫妇收养了一个孩子，而这个孩子碰巧是个女孩，那么这个女孩将无法向与她性别相同的母亲来倾诉。
He is a male playing the role of a mother.
而他是一个扮演母亲角色的男性。
She will not have a role model, neither will she be able to ask the male parent about her physical growth as her hormonal changes.
她不会有一个榜样，当她的荷尔蒙发生变化时，也不能够询问这个男性家长她有关她的生长发育。
Likewise, it will be the same case for a boy who grows in a lesbian environment.
同样的，对一个在女同性恋环境中长大的男孩也是如此。
These boys and girls will grow up in a very warped, dysfunctional family.
这些男孩和女孩是在一个不正常的家庭里面成长的。
Pray for these children.
我们需要为这些孩子们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Because they are confused.
因为他们被困，感到困惑。
They don't have a role model.
他们没有一个榜样。
So right now, I just pause here for a while.
所以我想先暂停一下。
Now, for all of us who has a family,
作为我们所有的家庭
，all of us have a for all of us who have a normal family.
当我们所有都有一个正常的家庭
，a normal family means a father and a mother.
正常的家庭是一位父亲和一位母亲。
We need to sort out.The roles, responsibilities, and expectation of each other.
我们要把他们的角色和职责都要定义清楚。
The father must play the role of the father.
父亲要扮演父亲的角色。
The mother must play the role of a mother.
母亲要扮演母亲的角色。
They must model what it is like to be the head of the house for the child.
他们要为孩子做好家一家之主的榜样。
For the boys in the family.
对男孩来说
，For the mother to show forth to the girls in the family what it's supposed to be like to be a mother, to be a wife, to be a daughter to the grandparent.
而母亲要为他们的女儿做好榜样，什么是妻子、女儿
？And at this juncture, I would like to say that if your marriage is on a rock,
在这个时候，如果你的婚姻现在正是经历挫折的时候
，It is good for the couple to resolve all the differences.In your marriage, so that it will give a good and warm environment for the children.
如果婚姻出现问题，那么父亲和母亲这个时候应该好好的来处理婚姻中的问题，才能为他们的孩子在家庭中做好榜样。
I don't think there are a lot of children in our church who is confused in regards to their gender.
我不认为在我们的教会里有很多孩子有性别困惑问题。
If there are,
但是如果有的话
it is important for the couple to resolve their differences first.
很重要的是夫妇两人要先解决他们之间的问题
So that the children will be able to have a role model at home.
这样孩子在家里就有好的榜样
They will feel secure in a loving environment.
他们会在一个爱的环境里感到非常有安全感
And then build that unconditional love.Foundation for your children.
为你的孩子创造一个无条件的爱的环境
And journey with them.
跟他们同行
So sort out the husband and wife problem first.
所以解决夫妻两人之间的问题首先
Take time to build an unconditional love environment.
花时间来建立这个无条件的爱的环境
Carve out time to spend with each and every child in the family.
把时间留出来跟家里的每个孩子一起
It is important that we do it now when they are young.
非常重要的是，在他们还小的时候，我们做这件事。
Don't wait until they become a teenager.
不要等到他们已经十几岁了才做。
I'll share with you the challenges later.
我要跟大家分享这个挑战，稍后再跟大家分享。
The next point I want to make to you is God created male and female.
接下来我们想说，神建立了造男造女。
We must return to the Bible to bring clarity to a confused generation.
我们必须要回到圣经中为困惑的一代人来解惑。
It is unfortunate that certain post-Christian countries have already thrown the Bible out of schools and parents have gone away from the Lord.
不幸的是，某些后基督教国家已经把圣经扔出了学校，家长也离开了主。
There are no moral bearings in the family or the city and even the nation.
家庭、城市甚至国家都没有道德观念。
Verse 27 says, "So God created man in His own image; in the image of God He created him. Male and female He created them."
创世纪一章二十七节，神就照着自己的形象造人，乃是照着他的形象造男造女。
God is a God of order.
神是讲秩序的神。
He is not a God of confusion.
他不是混乱制造者。
He is not confused.
他也不困惑。
God purposefully created the distinctive difference between a man and a woman.
神有意制造了男人和女人之间的不同。
It is declared at birth by the doctor, even though the gender can already be identified in the womb.
即使性别在我们还子宫中已经被确定，医生还是在出生的时候会宣布这个性别。
There are children who are open to gender fluidity, be a gender, and get to choose their sexual orientation.
孩子们对性取向的流动性和无性别者持开放的态度，并可以选择他们的性取向。
Now, you might say, Pastor Daniel, all this is not happening in Shanghai.
你可能会说，牧师，这个在上海不可能发生。
Maybe it's happening in America, in Britain, in all the Western countries.
可能在美国、英国或者西方国家在发生。
If you're free,
如果你有空的话
，I think many of you are already watching some of this video.
我相信你们很多人都看过了这些视频。这个其实是非常微妙的
example, ，OK？
让我给大家一个例子。
If you are to watch some of the WeChat channels，
你可能如果你看一些微信的频道，
快手
或者快手
，Right？、嗯、you will see this video，
你会看一些短视频
of a group of ladies，
有一群女孩
with crop hair， very short hair，
有非常短的头发
，dressed like a man，
穿的像一个男孩一样
，in various outfits。
因穿着不同
man,
各种不同的衣服，装扮成一个男人。
And I'm very thankful for China, actually.
我其实非常感激在中国。
China made the decision.
中国已经做了一个决定。
All actors must be macho.
所有的
very manly.
所有的男演员必须要有男性气概。
China don't like 娘娘腔 man. I think it's good.
我认为这是非常好的。
I think the television, the internet, and everything has to be regulated.
我认为所有的电视网络都应该被好好的监管。
Let me tell you what the Bible says about cross-dressing.
我想告诉大家，圣经是怎么说这种换装的。
Look at Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
申命记二十二章五节。
A woman shall not wear anything that pertains to a man, nor a man puts on a woman's garment. For all who do so are an abomination to the Lord your God.
妇女不可穿戴男子所穿戴的，男子也不可穿妇女的衣服，因为这样行都是耶和华你神所憎恶的。
Now, while we do read about such practices of people cross-dressing in the Bible, but it's an abomination in the eyes of the Lord.
虽然在圣经里人们有过这样变装的习俗，但在主眼里这是可憎的。
All these are happening because of the fallen nature of man.
所有这些在发生是因为人的堕落。
Some families might be facing the challenge from your children because they are an advocate of this belief that one should let the person choose their gender orientation.
有的家庭可能面临来自孩子的挑战，就是孩子成了选择自己性别取向的代言人。
There are a lot of confusion about their gender. That's the reason why some are agender.
有很多来自性别方面的困惑，也就是为什么有些人声称自己是无性别者。
It all depends on their mood.
都取决于他们当天的心情。
Now, next week I'm going to address about homosexuality.
下个星期我会讲同性恋的事情。
If we don't address at the earlier stage about gender confusion, it will lead to homosexuality.
如果我们不在孩子小的时候跟他们讲一下这个性别困惑的事情，有可能将来就会导致同性恋。
It will be a very dysfunctional family.
那会成为非常失效的家庭。
What the young people are saying today is their parents are not open to change.
今天的年轻人们说他们的父母不能接受改变。
Some people will say, "Oh, Pastor Daniel, the Bible is outdated."
有的人会说，牧师，这个圣经已经过时了。
The Bible must be relevant to the lifestyle of today.
圣经要跟今天的生活方式相关才对。
That's the reason why some churches has gone to choose that.Homosexuality is okay just to be relevant.
这也是为什么有的教会选择接受同性恋，因为他们想要跟社会相关。
Some of the children might say, "Oh, we are, you know, your gen. What gen are you? You are baby boomers. You belong to the baby boomers generation."
有的孩子会问你们到底是属于哪个世代的？
60年出生的。
六零年代的。
We are 2000. We are born in the year 2000.
而我们是2000年出生的。
Or 2010.
甚至是2010年代出生的。
Our thinking is different.
我所有的事情都已经不同了。
Our parents are not catching up.
我们的父母都落伍了。
I mean, it's okay to be traditional.
其实保持传统是很好的。
I think it is important for us to go back to the Bible.
我认为非常重要的是我们回到圣经。
It is important for us to guide them with the biblical perspective.
从圣经的角度来指引他们。
Okay, now let me explain to you why the world is going through all this right now.
让我跟大家再解释一下，为什么这个世界又在经历这一切。
Now, for non-Christian,
对于非基督徒来说
，they're not born again.
他们并没有重生。
Their spirit man is separated from God.
他们的灵人是跟神隔绝的。
There is a longing to worship something.
他们的心里空虚，想要敬拜一些某一项东西。
So, to a certain extent, gender confusion is something that they worship.
在某种程度上说，性别困惑其实是他们敬拜的一种东西。
So when they are not born again,
所以他们还没有被重生。
They are living in the realm of the soul.
他们活在魂的领域里面。
Now let me give you an example.
让我给大家一个例子。
In the Church of Ephesus,
在以弗所教会。
During that time,
在那个时候
，there was this goddess of Diana.
那个时候有个叫 Diana 的，他们所敬拜的神。
It is a fertility god.
是一个生育的神。
And it is there are temple prostitutes.
那时候还有寺庙里的妓女。
Yeah, there was a lot of confusion.
那时候有很多的困惑。
It was also a spirit of lust.
那也是一种情欲的诱惑。
The devil have different way of tempting people to stray away from God.
魔鬼有很多种方式来把人从神身边吸引走。
So before they were saved.
所以他们被得救之前
，They were dead in their sins and trespasses.
他们死在他们的过犯罪恶之中。
They live according to the lust of the flesh.
他们随从他们当时的风俗的情欲。
They're influenced by the prince of the power of the air.
他们被空中掌权者所影响。
Their thinking is full of vain things.
他们的思想全都是一些私欲。
Why are their thinking full of vain things? It's because everything that they feed from the internet that's negative.
因为他们从网络上拿到的所有的东西都是负面的。
Let me show you something very frank, okay?
我跟大家很坦白的分享一下。
You know, sometimes when you read about a man being caught taking upskirt photos, 就是当你读到在新闻有一些男士用他们的手机拍女生，不大合适的部位的时候，你会问为什么这个人会这么做 ，right?You ask yourself why? Why would these people do that?
你会问为什么这些人这么做
？If you are to check their handphone,
如果你检查他的手机的话
，If you were to check their laptop history,
或者你检查他的电脑的历史
，They will probably be full of pornographic site.
可能有很多的这些
色情
的网络网站。
Right? Because their thoughts, the soul is their mind.
因为他们的思想
，their mind will be full of these thoughts.
全都是被这些所占据。
And if they go by what they see,
如果他们按照他们的感官所看到的
，if they see sexy woman,
如果他们看到性感的女人
，the lust of the eyes will attract them,
眼中的情欲就会吸引他们。
And because of what they have been meditating upon,
因为他们心中都是空虚
，they will live their life like that.
他们就会如此生活。
Because the soul is the king.
因为魂是他们的，在他们心中作王。我是我自己。
So if you listen to all these children who are confused,
如果你听一听这些困惑的孩子们
，It's always about how they feel.
都是他们如何感觉。
Feeling is not accurate.
而感觉是不准确的。
Right?
对吗
？Am I right? Yes. Feelings are never accurate. If you live by feelings,
感觉从来不准确。如果你按感觉生活的话
，Your life will be chaotic.
你的生活就会一片混乱。
So that's why, you know, when The unbelievers practices LGBTQ.
所以当非信徒来按照 LGBTQ 来生活的话
，when they have no security of love，
当他们没有爱的安全感的时候
，when they're looking for love，
当他们寻求爱的时候
，when they're very insecure in their life，
当他们在生活中非常没有安全感。
If they're an example, just one example.
举例
Okay, let's say your children were to go to all girls school.
假设说你的孩子去的是一个女校。
She's not good academically.
她学习不太好。
She's not good in sports.
在运动也不太好。
She might not be very good looking.
她可能长得也没有那么漂亮。
She might be not very nice in terms of her figure.
她的身材可能也没那么好。
She might not be very tall.
可能也不高。
She's not outstanding in any way.
她在各方面都不出色。
What is one way to feel accepted?
那么她感觉到被接纳的方式是什么呢
？To be different.
就是与众不同。
To catch the attention of everybody.
来抓住别人的注意力。
Is to show that they love the same sex.
就是展现出她是同性恋。
Because they don't have love.
因为他们缺乏爱。
They are not receiving love at home.
他们在家里没有得到足够的爱。
They are not accepted by their peers because they are not good in anything.
也没有被同学所接受，因为他们各方都不出色。这是他身份的危机。
You know, gender confusion is also an identity crisis.
性别的困惑也是一个身份危机，因为他们被各种媒体所影响，明星所影响，这些影响。
And when they go home.
当他们回到家的时候
Nobody is at home.
没有人在家里
No parent is telling them what is right or what is wrong.
没有父母告诉他们什么是对错
They are not safe.
他们没有被得救
They will be an advocate of LGBTQ.
他们会去倡导 LGBTQ.
But as a Christian,
作为基督徒
Praise God, once we are saved,
感谢主一旦我们得救
How can we be different?
我们如何可以
I started off by saying that we can be different.
我们可以不同。
And I tell you why the world is behaving like this.
我也告诉你了世界为什么如此行。
And then after we are saved,
那当我们得救以后
how can we be different?
我们怎么样才可以与世界不同
Turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4 to 6.
我们一起看哥林多后书十章四到六节。
Now, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds, casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.Bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ and being ready to punish all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled.
我们征战的兵器本不是属血气的，乃是在神面前有能力可以攻破坚固的营垒，将各样的计谋、各样拦阻人认识神的那些自高之事一概攻破了，又将人所有的心意夺回，使他都顺服基督，并且我已经预备好了，等你们十分顺服的时候，要责罚那一切不顺服的人。
Okay, let's go to the diagram.
让我们回到这个图表。
I said, you are born again.
我们说你重生了。
You are brand, you are new creation.
你是全新的人。
You have the nature of God.
你有神的性情。
You are growing strong in with the word of God.
你在神的话语与里面
茁壮成长。The apostle said to walk in the spirit.
你在灵里面运作。
And then to renew your mind with the word of God.
用神的话语来更新你的心思意念。
Now, let's say you are.Born again at 40 years old.
假设说你在四十岁的时候得救。
You're 40 years of worldly indoctrination.
你有四十年都生活在属世的生活中。
If you're exposed to gender fluidity.
如果那个时候你就接受了性别的这个流动性、性取向流动性。
Or someone who just became a Christian but had a practice of homosexuality.
或者是刚刚接受基督的同性恋。
Now.If the homosexual were to be saved,
如果同性恋者被 得救
how can their life be different after that?
他们的生活如何才能不同呢
They need to learn to walk in the spirit.
他们要学会在灵里行走
And then to renew their mind with the word of God.
用神的话语来更新他们的心意 如何更新
Father, I praise you that I'm born again.
天父，我赞美你，我重生了
There are precious promises that help me to escape the corruption in the world through lust.
有你宝贵的应许帮助我来摆脱这个世界的情欲。
The Holy Spirit is living in my heart.
圣灵居住在我心里。
Is able to help me to overcome all temptation.
可以帮助我克服各种诱惑。
Is that what the Bible says?
这是圣经所说的吧。
I'm no longer a slave to sin.
我不再是罪的奴仆。
I'm a slave of righteousness.
我是公义的奴仆。
I'm a slave of love.
我是爱的奴仆。
And God made male and female.
而神造男造女。
I'm a male.
我是男人
I love a woman,
我爱女人
I will marry a woman,
我会和一个女人结婚
That is how they renew their mind.
这是他如何更新他的心意
So let me go back to the realm of the soul.
我们回到魂的领域
So after they are born again,
当他们重生之后
when they have these feelings,
当他们有这样的感觉的时候
Because we still live in a fallen body,
因为我们还是住在我们败坏的肉体里面
The body will not be glorified until Jesus comes back or when we go to heaven.
直到我们去到天堂或者主归来我们的肉体才会得荣耀。
Our body will send us signals.
这个肉体仍旧给我们各种信号。
But how do we overcome?
但我们怎么克服它
？We pull down every wrong thoughts.
我们抓住所有的错误的思想。
Say no, I'm not a homosexual.
我不是一个同性恋者。
No, I'm not confused.
不，我没有被，我没有困惑。
I'm a new creation.
我是一个新造的人。
I'm born again.
我重生了。
I have the nature of God.
我有神的性情在我里面。
I'm able to have self-control.
我可以有自我的控制。
I'm not dictated by my feelings.
我不被我的感觉所控制。
I'm not dictated by my senses.
我也不被我的各种感官所控制。
I grew and reign through the spirit man.
我的灵人在成长。
That help me to overcome the temptation.
帮助我来克服这些诱惑。
I bring all those thoughts.
我抓住所有这些想法
All those negative thoughts,
抓住所有那些负面的想法
those thoughts that has been a stronghold in my mind,
那些是我心目中的营垒
that I'm confused that I love a man,
那些想法是就如果我是个男人的话我被困惑
said,
我爱男人
in the name of Jesus,
我会说在 按耶稣的名、
嗯、You submit
我顺服
Submit to what the Bible says
我将所有的这些想法，我要顺服于圣经的圣经的说。
Let's say a homosexual man become a Christian.
假设说一个同性恋的男人变成一个基督徒。
I want to break free from all this.
他说：“我想从这一切中被解救出来。我已经重生了。我选择不再去爱男人。
God institute marriage between a man and a woman.”
而神在男女之间安排了婚姻。
I'll marry a woman.
我会和女人结婚。
And during that marriage relationship,
在这个婚姻里面
I will not run my life based on my feelings towards unnatural love.
我不会再被那不自然的爱所控制。
I will have self-control.
我会有自我控制。
I'll live out the life that God intended for me to live.
我会按照神想要我的生活方式去生活。
Do you follow? And then the person will break away.
然而这个人就可以得救了。
Because of the power of the Holy Spirit that lives in him.
因为有圣灵的力量住在他里面。
And with the help of the renewing of the mind.
而且有更新的心意在他里面。
So that's why it is important for us to welcome all kinds of people into the church.
所以对我们来说非常重要的是我们欢迎所有的人来到教会
Because God died for the ungodly
因为神是为那些不敬虔的人而所舍命而舍命的
All people can be saved including you and I
所有那些不敬虔的人都可以得救
so, closing,
包括你我
How are you supposed to journey with your children?
所以作为结语你要如何跟你的孩子同行呢
I believe that it's very important for parents to journey with them from especially during the formative years of their lives
我相信非常重要的是父母在孩子们非常小的时候就跟他们一起同行
And I can tell you by the time a child turns 8 years old
当他们八岁的时候
In this present time
在现今的时代
Because of the availability of the internet
因为网络的接触网络
They are very independent in their thinking
他们在自己的思想里面已经很独立了
As they grow into a teenager
当他们长成为十几岁以后
They are different way of managing our children
有不同的方式来管理我们的孩子
I mean just like you husband and wife
就像你们夫妻
You won't say me doesn't you Jane submit right
你不会说你一定要顺服我你听我的
Your wife will say
你太太可能就笑一笑
say some likewise for your children
同样的对你的孩子
you will cannot say I'm daddy you listen to me
你也不能说我是老爸你得听我的
it doesn't work this way
这样是行不通的
you know that you of today will observe your life
你知道那些孩子们如今都在观察你的生活
Dad, you say you're Christian right
哦、oh, 你说你是基督徒是吗
I observe your life every day
我每天都观察你的生活
are you sure you're Christian
你确定你是基督徒吗
And youth are different.
青少年们是不同的。
Why is it so important to build the foundation of unconditional love?
所以在家庭里面建造一个无条件爱的环境是非常重要的。青少年们。
Law and rules without love will cause rebellion.
没有爱的各种规矩会导致他们叛逆。
If you don't spend quality time with your children,
如果你不好好的花时间跟他们在一起
if you don't love them based on their love language,
你不用他们的爱的语言来爱他们
if you don't journey with them,
不与他们同行
if you're always not around,
你总是不在他们身边
and when things like this happen, they are influenced by the world,
当这种事情发生的时候他们就会被世界所影响
you're shocked,
你那个时候震惊了
and you want to come in and intervene,
你想要介入进去来解决
but what every parent will say, you should listen to me,
你可能就会说你要听我的
This is what the Bible says
这是圣经所说的
It doesn't work that way
那样行不通
It will be a very long journey.
这会是一个非常漫长的旅程。
You might even need to discuss with your spouse and say someone should actually work part time or stop work and learn, live on one income.
你可能需要跟你的伴侣讨论，其中的一方需要停止工作。
It is during this time where you have to question yourself, what do you value most?
在这样的时期，你就想要问自己，你所珍视的、重视的是什么
？Is your career more important than your children who are being affected by the world's values?
你的事业更重要吗？还是你被世界的价值观所影响的孩子更重要
？Because if you don't address it now,
如果你现在不去解决它
，I'll talk about it next week.
我下个星期就会讲。
What some of the families will look like?
有的家庭会变成什么样子
？Money will not be able to buy back your influence over your children.
金钱并不能买回你对你孩子的影响力。
Once you cross this time of opportunity to speak into their lives.
一旦你错过了这段时期的这个好机会
，You cannot buy back that time.
你不能再把这个时间买回来。
So in closing,
所以作为结论
，Bringing up our children in the ways of the Lord is not just to bring them to church on Sunday, although it is an important thing to do.
按主的方式抚养孩子，并不只等同于把他们带到教会来，尽管来教会是很重要的。
Bringing up the children in the ways of the Lord is a daily affair.
按主的方式抚养孩子是我们每天的工作。
It is doing a devotion with them.
是跟他们一起做灵修。
Sharing with them what we believe as Christians when they share with you.
当他们跟你分享的时候，你也跟他们分享作为基督徒是怎么样的。
We must not be judgmental towards them.
不要评判他们。
At different stages of their life, we should love them with love and logic.
在他们不同的生命阶段，爱他们，用爱和逻辑爱他们。
Explain to them why you believe what you believe.
跟他们解释为什么你相信你所相信的。
Explain to them why you discipline them.
也跟他们解释为什么你要管教他们。
It is done out of the foundation of unconditional love.
这是出于无条件的爱的这个基础。
So when you do that,
所以当你这样做的时候
，you will have a wonderful family.
你就会有一个非常好的、非常棒的家庭。
Let's bow our head and pray.
让我们低头祷告。
With every head bowed and our eyes closed.
当所有人低头祷告的时候
，I'd like to ask a very critical question.
我想问一个非常重要的问题。
If you're listening to this sermon and you're not a Christian,
如果你今天听到这段讲道，你还不是基督徒
，You have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
你还没有接受耶稣基督做你的救主。
But you'd like to receive Him today.
但是你今天想要接受他
，I'd like to pray with you.
我想跟你一起祷告。
Say this prayer after me.
请跟我一起祷告。
Say, Dear Heavenly Father,
说慈爱的天父
，Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me on the cross.
感谢你派耶稣基督在十字架上为我舍命。
Forgive me of my sin, for I'm a sinner.
请原谅我的罪，因为我是个罪人。
Come into my heart today.
今天就进入我的心。
Be my Lord and Savior.
做我的主，做我的救主。
In Jesus' name, I pray.
奉主耶稣的名求。
Amen.
Amen.
If you have said that prayer,
如果你说了这段祷告
，I'd like to hear from you.
我想要听到你跟我联系。
My email address is written at the bottom of this page.
我的邮箱地址就在屏幕的下方。
I'd like to connect with you.
我想要跟你联系。
Let me pray for the rest of us.
让我为大家众多的弟兄姐妹祷告。
Father, we praise you and thank you that you have given us the Bible.
天父，我们感谢赞美你赐予我们圣经。
It is the handbook for our lives.
这是我们生命的生命手册。
Help every parents to journey with their children.
请帮助所有的父母跟他们的孩子同行。
Help them to bring up their children in your ways.
帮助他们按你的方式抚养他们的孩子。
So that when they grow up, they will not depart from you.
当他们长大的时候，他们就不会远离你。
I pray that there will be good conversation at the dining table.
我祷告在他们的饭桌上有好的对话。
And I pray that Father, you will bless them holistically.
我祷告天父，你会全然的祝福他们。
Now may the love of the Father,
愿天父的慈爱
，the grace of Lord Jesus Christ,
主耶稣基督的恩惠
，and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.
圣灵的感动与交通与你同在，从今直到永远。
Amen.
Amen.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the service today and thank you so much for joining us. And I know that you've been encouraged by the preaching of the word, that you know that God loves you and he has good thoughts toward you. You can continue to follow us on our website, and our social media accounts in YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram, or simply drop us an email to keep in touch.And here at ICS, we're a church, we're a family that's blessed to bless the community and the nations. So we hope that you were blessed today and you're really trying to think about how you can be a blessing, to your neighbors and those around you. Well, we hope you have a great Sunday ahead, and we look forward to seeing you real soon. God bless.